getting areas of burnt reed, which have been burnt regularly, or was it you? Anyway, he knows the story.
We study mesolithic sites from all over the place, but there's very, very few sites where everything is well preserved and stratified that helps us answer questions about sites that are less well preserved. So if you lose the good sites like Star Car, it makes all the other sites much more difficult to understand.
The thing is, the Mesolithic existed a very long time ago. We're talking 8, 9, 10,000 years ago, and there are very few sites like Star Car. Star Car is a really unique site. We have lots of Mesolithic sites, but we have very few like Star Car. And I think what Star Car provides in terms of understanding the Mesolithic life and the Mesolithic world and so on probably is unique in Britain.
It's become the most famous Mesolithic site in Europe, so everybody's heard of it. Every student has written an essay at some stage. And no other site in Britain has produced the wealth of bone and antler and wood material that this site has produced. So it is enormously important. It's still a completely unique site in Britain. And there are very few, perhaps only one or two other sites of this sort of period of the early Mesolithic in the rest of Europe. But it's also just a wonderful place to be. Every time I come here, it feels a right place to be.
We've just hit, at the top of the trench, we've just hit the sand, which looks like the surface, the archaeological surface. So we're going to be stopping just above there so we can trowel down. It's a bit shallower than we were expecting, but we can at least extend the trench further down so it's into the lake a bit further down. And it'd be nice because we get a nice sequence from the dry land into the wet, hopefully.
Want a tea?
No.
We put this hole in as part of a sampling process, which we do right across the lake. So every 15 metres, we put a test pit in just to see if we have any signs of human occupation or not. And quite often, we get empty trenches, which tells us that there isn't any human occupation in those areas, and then occasionally we do get some signs, and sometimes it's lots of flint. But this time we've got a couple of pieces of bone, and this is one of them. It could be various things. It could be telling us that in this area we've got some signs of human occupation. It looks like here. It looks like the bone. It's not a complete bone. It would have been the other end would be very similar to this, and it's been cut across here. It looks like it's been cut, but it could be a break. And again, a specialist needs to tell us that. But that could be an indication that it's been humanly modified. It's always exciting to find something like this because it just tells us that this is another place that we need to investigate further. And it might be yet another location around the lake where we've got signs of people living.